Hey guys, hey girls. Welcome once again to another flip session today. So presently in class, we've been talking about the gas laws. That's our current unit. How do gases behave? So today's flip video is going to focus on another gas law. In this case, Dalton's law of partial pressures. So what is it, right? So Dalton basically states that if you have a mixture of different gases in a container, the total pressure of all of the gases that make up that mixture, okay, are going to be subdivided into partial pressures of each gas. In other words, the total pressure of all of the gases is the sum of the pressure that each individual gas exerts on the walls of that container vessel. So this P1 is the partial pressure of gas 1 plus the partial pressure of gas 2 and so on. So we can look at these as partial pressures. Okay. As a side note, in some cases when a gas is collected over water, some of the liquid water vaporizes and creates water vapor pressure, and it's dependent upon the temperature at which the vessel is contained. Okay, so just kind of keep that in mind. Water vapor does exert a pressure. I can't talk today for some reason. All right, so let's take a look at it. What do you need to know for Dalton's law? Right, well, this concept of mole fraction. So the variable X is used for this term called mole fraction. And what a mole fraction basically is, it's the ratio of the number of moles of a particular gas that you're looking for. So let's say gas 1, for example, divided by the total moles, N total, N stands for number of moles. It's going to give us the ratio of moles of gas that we're looking for divided by the total number of moles. So it's basically a percentage, it's a fraction, right? And this is going to help us determine Dalton's law today, right? So mole fraction, right? Ratio of moles of a gas related to the total number of gas moles in the gas mixture, right? What I just said, okay? So mole fraction of the gas, the number of moles of that particular gas divided by the total moles of the gas mixture, okay? All right, so let's take a look at this. So each gas in a mixture is going to act independently of the other gases that are in that mixture. For example, think of our atmosphere. Our atmosphere has nitrogen and argon and oxygen and CO2 and a myriad of other gases. Each one of those gases exerts a certain mole fraction or pressure within the total pressure of our atmosphere for that particular gas, right? So here's a problem I'd like you to try. I'm going to take you through this step by step. So we have a gas mixture with the following gases, and the total pressure of all the gases is 3.25 atmospheres, or atmospheric pressures, okay? So this is our P total, okay? I need a new marker, don't I? All right, that's our P total. All right. Oh, I missed. All right, so here's what we got. We got 10 grams of O2 gas, 6 grams of H2, and 20 grams of argon. Right. So we have to figure out, we know that all three gases exert a total pressure of 3.25 atm, but we want to know what's the partial pressure in atm of each one of those gases. Right? So the way to tackle this problem is you have to compare these various gases mole to mole, and you can find the mole fraction, right, which would eventually tell you how much partial pressure each gas exerts. So here's what I did. I took these masses of each gas and I converted them to moles of each gas simply by dividing by the molar mass of each one of these three gases, right? So 10 grams of O2 divided by the molar mass of O2, which is 32 grams, gets me my number of moles of O2, okay? 6 grams of H2 gas divided by its molar mass, 2.02, gets me 2.97 moles of H2. And 20 grams of argon divided by argon's molar mass 39.95 grams gets me 0.5, right? So if I look at my molar ratios here, I can tell right away that H2 definitely makes up more of this mixture. So therefore, H2 should, in theory, exert more pressure, more force than oxygen and argon, simply because we have more moles of H2. Okay. So what I need to do next is divide each one of these separate mole amounts of each gas by the sum of their total. Okay. And in the next slide, here's what I did. So the mole fraction X of oxygen gas is the number of moles of O2, which we just calculated in the previous slide, divided by the sum of all of my numerators here, right? Now, what does this even mean, right? It's easy to get lost in the numbers, but I'm basically getting a percentage. I'm getting what fraction of the total moles does each of the three gases exert, okay? So my number of moles of O2 divided by the total moles of all three gases, that's a really small number, right? That would be 8.26% of the total pressure is exerted by oxygen. We didn't have a whole lot of it, if you remember. We only had a third of a mole of oxygen. Look at N2. It makes up the bulk of my mixture, 78.51%, right? We have the most hydrogen than the other two gases. And I did the same for argon, right? So I have my mole fractions here, which are percentages. Now, to find out the total pressure, I would simply take the mole fraction of each gas, which is the first number here, and multiply that. If you remember, this was our total pressure of all three gases given in the problem. So in other words, what is 8% of the total pressure, right? What is 78%, I'm rounding these numbers, of the total pressure? What's 13% of the total pressure? And the answer here is this, right? So oxygen is exerting this much pressure. 2.55 atm's are the partial pressure of hydrogen gas. And finally, 0.430 atm's are the pressures for argon. All right. So this is a Dalton Laws problem. And sometimes it's not so straightforward as you saw in this last problem. And sometimes I just simply give you the partial pressures and ask you to determine what's the total pressure. All right. There's going to be another flip video made on a practice problem for you to try. And as always, I'll see you in class. And if you have any difficulties or problems, please ask. All right. Until next time, guys. Good luck.